If you want to make this kind of 3D become like this, or maybe this, into this, well, I'll share your steps.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the Kriya Rupa channel, and today I want to share you how I make a background for webtoon. This is the easy steps. This is really simple, and all you can do just make sure you have a sketch model. This is what I make. This is actually the train station, the waiting area, and there is supposed to be train here, but I don't really need that. So I need to just make sure this model of SketchUp already, detailed, and make sure you already put a material perfectly. So the next step is make sure how feel you want to make. For example, I want to the feel maybe just from the front like this. This is the front, but what part of front of the station? We can just move it. I just want to make a background about, you know, this, there is something about the character just chattering, or maybe they're waiting for somewhere, maybe in here. Okay, I want to this chair in the middle, and okay, I think that's enough. After that, for the next steps, I need to make sure the shadow is checked, and make sure this, I want to just make the kind of shadow is about this time. Yeah, maybe pretty good. Yeah, for the edges. Yeah, don't really see the differences, but yeah, maybe I just let it just check them all. And then the next step is make the seam. I made it into a color and shadow. Oh, sorry. Okay. So, this scene, I want to make this kind of my own style. Okay, this is the current style I use is architectural design style, and I want to make a little bit more modification about this because I just want to make just a color and shadow. So all I need to do right now is make sure there is no edges, just a color and just a shadow. Okay, there is no edges already, and the material is maybe just nicer. And then the next step is about the scene. We make sure the scenes. Okay, the next scene, we can just make the next scene shadow only. I need to change it first into the shaded style. Now this one, I need to modify it again. No texture, just shade. Okay, this cool. This is what I want. And okay, the edges need to hide it again. So the next step, refresh my current scene. This one. Okay, the next step, we need a third scene. This is the last scene we need to make. I want to name it an edges. Just an edges, okay? Okay, so I need to just go to with the heat line. With the heat line, I made it an edges with profile 1. This is only the edges. You can see this is, I need to maybe just nicer. Yep. And this profile is 1. Okay, this is good. And then we refresh the scenes again. Update. So you can see the differences. This is the shadow only, and this is the color and shadow. See, there is no edges, and the edges just an edges. You can see this. Now, the next step is we can just export it into 2D graphics. I want to just make sure this into PNG file, and we can just name it first in the color shadow. Okay, and then we can just save it color and shadow, PNG color shadow, and export. This is the new look. Actually, this is just one look, and then the next look, we need to just export it one by one. Yes, okay. We need to patient. Keep your patient when you use SketchUp. Okay. Why it is? Oh, sorry. There is nothing. Okay. Next, we need to export it again. PNG shadow. Oops. Export it, and then the ages. Wait, this is ages, a real one. Nah, this one. I need this one. Okay, we need to update it again. Now, after that, we need to export it again, like before. This one, and the ages. Okay, done. This is done for the SketchUp. So we need to move into Photoshop. We can just open those three files with me. This thing and open. I need to make sure the color shadow is in the first layer. Alright, so I need to just move and drag it into the color and shadow files, and this one too. Then we simply just copy this. So this one, this is the shadow. I need to just name it shadow, and then this one edges. Is that true? Yeah, that's true. And this one is color shadow. And this one, don't really need that. Oh, first I need to just make sure this color shadow layers at about 100% opacity and 100% fill and the normal. And then about the edges, you can see we need to just make this opacity is about 40 and fill about 40 maybe. Yeah, that's cool. And then about this one, we can just make this maybe color burn. Yep, color burn is okay. It's okay. And this one, the shadow, this is the crucial. It's about maybe 50. Yep, 50. And then this, I need to make this into multiply. All right. So what I need to do right now, I need to just make this one a copy. Actually, this is not really important because I need to save the original layers. I name it into original page. Yeah, whatever. Just hide it, and then with the current layers, this new layers, I can just make this into yeah. And I need to copy this, and I want to make the color balances about what I want. This is the I can see I want to make this a little bit more, you know. In the want to nearest sunset thing, about the next step is I want to make it the wheel of webtoon thingy. Okay, which one you prefer? This one? This one okay as well. And maybe I just make this into a little bit more not strong enough. Maybe as you can see, yeah, cool. Then I need to just merge it and then copy it again. And this one, I need to, you know, the blur thingy. This one and then blur and the golden blur. And you just make sure this is not really too strong. Yeah, you know, this is actually the backgrounds, not really the object that you want to make pop up in your arts. Okay, this is you can just make this blurry. Maybe you can see this is so dreamy. I like this. Maybe not too strong. Yeah, something like that. Okay, this is done.
Thank you so much guys for watching. If you found this video useful, you can click that share button and spread it out to your other future friends. Bye.